bits this early in the season, and the older you get, the harder it gets to get back up and going.
King of the Klondike, Tony Beets, is starting his gold mining season 2 months early.
I don't know how these people do that retire. If I would retire, I'd be a corpse within a year.
You know, the best thing about your retirement is it'll also be your funeral, so it'll save a lot of money.
The biggest thing is this spring, get enough ground opened up for Mike, so we don't have to worry about that.
It's pretty good this morning. The D11 finally showed up. They built it brand new. They loaded up last week right out of the factory. Brand spanking new.
Tony wants a record 9,000-ounce gold haul this season, so he's invested $3.5 million in a 125-ton D11 dozer, a machine that should be able to strip through the frozen overburden at Paradise Hill.
We buy the new stuff, and we're going to do 9,000 ounces every year from now on. You can't do that with old crap. We're starting something new, so we put quite an investment in this year in order to, step it up.
Good.
Tony has already spent $1.4 million on a 950 excavator. With the D11, he's $1 million over Mini's $4 million equipment budget before he's finished spending.
Can't wait to see it all built together because it's going to look sexy. So good. Love it.
The D11, nice they got here just on time. You got with the road bands here in the spring when the frost comes out, when it starts to melt. Now you get your pavement that is black, that heats up. If you get too much load on there, you punch the pavement out. You roll it right out of the road. If you don't get it in before the road bends come on, you lose 2 months out of the season, which is a lot. So right now, let's get it done. Let's get it over it.
We're moving then.
Yep.
Weight limits on the Yukon roads mean the monster D11 has been broken into pieces for transport. To get the dozer off the lowboy, two 25,000-pound track frames need to be lifted onto mounting pins on the body of the 11. Then two 10,000-pound tracks will be slid into position and hoisted over the track frames using the dozer's main drive wheel. The tracks will have a final link attached. Only then can the D11 drive off the lowboy and the next stage of the build start.
I'm just paranoid because I'm using my tracks, and this thing is notorious because it'll start swinging if you're not very careful.
And then you can smoke someone, and if you're lucky, that's just a bad day for him. If you're unlucky, that's a bad last day for him.
Now we're gonna turn this around, and you should be able to spin it, and then I can see how far I can swing her in. If you could, please.
Mike must perfectly line up the swinging 25,000-pound track frame to the pin on the body of the 11.
You're good?
That's good there, Mike. Okay, let's find some bolts. Hard bar pin in, and then we'll bolt that retainer up.
It might be nice to see the first track frame on. At least we're making some progress. Gentlemen, come and give me a hand, hook it up. Throw one over there, throw one over there. Hook the other one up same way. Go like this, long as we're coming.
And hook them up. The trailer is too low, so now we need to lift this sideways so we can get the track underneath it. And that means we're gonna have to do it again on the other side.
The D11 body now weighs 67 tons, the same as a US Army M1 tank.
There we go.
How's it lined up on that back bogey?
It looks good.
Okay. Yeah, we got her on.
It's starting to look pretty good. We got the track frames on. Now they're putting the tracks on.
Pull ahead a bit.
The 5-ton track is chained to the 11's main drive wheel and wound over the frame using only a fraction of the power in the 850 horsepower V12 engine.
just in time, he maybe still have a full turn as he falls out. If not, we'll cut it. They got a little bit of troubles because it's too smooth since everything is new. Give them another 15, 20 minutes, they'll have the other side on, and then we should be ready to roll them off. Then they got another day, and then we should have a cab ready to go.
We're just gonna lift it up, try and pull it back a bit, and then we can start working on trying to connect the track up.
While the tracks have their final 277-pound links fitted,
oh, that was nice.
Tony takes a look at his $3.5 million cab.
The cabs are actually quite nicely designed. Now I just gotta figure out where the controls for the heated seat are.
Probably on your touch screen.
Okay.
So you'll be ready to walk off in a minute,
yeah.
Huh?
We gotta drop the trailer and then Mike can walk it off.
Perfect. Be nice to get it going. If we're gonna do 9,000 ounces this year, we better get the thing on the go.
Yes, sir.
Good, Mike!
Oh my God, this thing drives nice. Holy crap, those brakes kick in quick.
Yeah, sounds nice, huh?
Hey, Dad, I like my new office.
You do like your new office, do you?
I found the heat seat. My ass is nice and warm.
Oh, nice.
She's a smooth ride already, I can tell.
That's good. I'm better to be.
For the price, yeah.
Getting everything ready, and then we're going to drive the dozer into the blade, connect everything up, and get near the end here.
Test it in the center of the blade. It's all good. There you go. Gotta get straight above the hole, boom up. Let me put the ripper jack in. That'll be the last piece to be done. Up the hill she goes, off the works she goes.
The 10-ton ripper shank should allow Tony to tear through the frozen Yukon dirt.
Back up a bit more. There we go.
Ooh, that is a big.
Oh, yeah. It's up there, right?
Yeah, she's over. And she's definitely wider.
I think that's the first brand new D11 in Yukon.
The D11 heads straight to work at Paradise Hill, where Tony will test its stripping power. If it works, he'll be 2 months ahead of schedule.
To get used to this, just the ripper controls you're not used to. What I'm doing is I'm prying out solid frost. Peels that frost right out of there. I used to do this 14 hours a day, every day. I used to rip for 8 hours and then I used to push for 6 hours. We used to do that for 3-4 months and then we used the sluice. Let's see if we can push a little bit of frost out with this bulldozer. We want to get 9,000 ounces, then we're gonna have to do some serious stripping. You have to upgrade. You have to get the iron. You gotta work with the equipment, not work on it. To bust that frost out of there like nothing. We needed something that was reliable. I think this machine is absolutely gonna do that. Definitely will be a game changer.